Good morning. I am Simpy. Welcome to EVS class. Let's start the further discussion. Your pre-midterm examination is going to be held from 2nd of September. So first, we will talk about the examination, what's the syllabus, what's the paper pattern. All of you know that what is the syllabus of EVS for pre-midterm examination? Syllabus is chapter 1 to chapter 4. To chapter 4, this one is the syllabus for EVS. You have to study 4 chapters for the pre-midterm examination, chapter 1 to chapter 4, all of you know. And total marks 50 marks of questions will be there. 25 marks MCQ MCQ means multiple choice questions. Options will be given and you have to choose the right ones. And for 25 marks descriptive type of questions. See, answer in one sentence, 4 questions, each question contains 1 mark, total 4 marks. Then section B, answer in 2 sentences, each question contains 2 marks and there will be 4 questions, total 8 marks. Then section C, each question contains 3 marks. 3 questions, total 9 marks. And then last, draw and level, this question contains 4 marks. Total 25, 4, 8, 9, 4. Total 25 marks. 25 marks MCQ. And 25 marks descriptive. Then total marks 50. Now all of you know about the paper pattern. 25 marks MCQ. And in 25 marks answer in one sentence. 1 marks. Then section B, answer in 2 sentences. Then section C, answer in 3 or more sentences. And then last question, draw and leveling. Total this one is for 25 marks. So 50 marks of questions will be there in the pre-midterm examination. Now all of you know about the paper pattern, that how you have to study for the examination, how you have to do the preparation for the examination. All of you write down this one in your notebooks about the paper pattern. Now we will start the revision part. We will revise chapter 1 today. Revision. Chapter 1. What is the title of the chapter 1? Do you remember? Our body. So we will revise this chapter now. All of you be ready for this one. Now see, first topic is organs. All of you know about the organs. Our body is made up of different organs like eyes, ears, nose, hands, legs. And how many types are there of organs? Do you know? Do you remember? We have already studied this one. There are 2 types of organs. External organs and internal organs. Now all of you write down the types of the organs in your notebooks. In the revision part, you have to write down this one in the revision part. एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स, इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गन्स, एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स एंड इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स। व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय द एक्सटर्नल ऑर्गन्स? द ऑर्गन्स लोकेटेड आउटसाइड आवर बॉडी आर कॉल्ड external organs. Outside our body we can see such types of organs. Now give me examples of external organs like eyes, ears, nose, chest. These are the examples of external organs, external body parts. And internal organs, what do you understand by internal organs? The organs located inside our body are called internal organs. Internal organs, we can see internal organs are located inside our body. Now give me examples of internal organs. Heart, lung, liver, intestines, etc. These are the examples of internal organs. Now all of you understood that what are organs, what are external organs and what are internal organs. Now you have to write down this one in your notebooks in the revision part. Just write down the revision and then write down external organs, internal organs, examples of external organs, examples of internal organs. Write down the definition of external organs, internal organs. Then you will come to know about the external and internal organs. This topic is very important for this chapter. So many questions may come from this topic in the examination. Now you have to study this one in the revision part. See, head. Now tell me about the head, neck. Tell me about the neck. Where are they located? The head and neck are located in the upper part of our body, and in the head, brain is located here. Brain is located inside the head. What is located inside the head? Brain. Question may come like this way, that which organ is located inside the head? Then answer is brain. Answer is brain. So you should know that where is brain located? Brain is located inside the head. It gives commands to all the parts of our body that what we have to do, what our organs have to do. And neck connects the head to the rest of our body. It helps the head to move in different directions. Now all of you move your body. See, your neck helps the head to move in different directions. Without neck, you can move your heads in different directions. Now move your head. Now all of you got it, all of you understood about head and neck. Now tell me what types of organs are there. They are external organs, they are external body parts, because they are located outside our body. They are located outside our body, so they are called external organs. Now see. Now come below chest. Abdomen. All of you know where are they located? The chest and abdomen are located in the center of our body. Now all of you look your chest and abdomen. Chest and abdomen are also part of the trunk. This one is the middle part. And chest contains internal organs, heart and lungs. Heart and lungs are the internal organs because they are located inside our body and they are protected by a rib cage. And abdomen is located below the chest abdomen is located. First chest and then below the chest abdomen is located. And it has internal organs, stomach and liver. Abdomen has internal organs, stomach and liver. And stomach and liver are internal organs because they are located inside our body. Now see arms. And legs. All of you know about arms and legs. Where are they located? The arms and hands are located in the upper part of our body, and the legs and feet are located in the lower part of our body. Arms, upper part. And legs, lower part. All of you know about the locations of these organs, that where are arms located and where are legs located. And the hands perform various activities. You can do so many activities with the help of hands. What can you do? Answer me, what can you do with the help of your hands? You can hold anything, you can touch anything, you can lift anything. And legs help us to stand, walk, run and dance. You can run because you have legs. You can dance with the help of your legs. You can walk with the help of your legs. Now all of you understood that what are the functions of arms and legs. They are so important organs of our body. And arms and legs are our external organs or internal organs? Answer me, external or internal? Arms and legs, we can see they are outside of our body, so they are external organs. They are external organs. Now all of you come to know about the organs, about the external organs, about the internal organs, about head and neck, chest and abdomen, arms and legs. So today, what's your assignment? You have to revise these topics. Organs. In organs, you have to revise external organs and internal organs. You have to revise this one. You have to learn the definitions of external organs, internal organs, examples of external organs, examples of internal organs, and locations of external organs, whatever we have studied, you should know. This one is your assignment. You have to revise these topics properly, whatever we have studied today, right now. In the next class, we will continue the further discussion of this chapter. We will continue the revision of this chapter. Now, it's time to wrap up the session. Thank you. Have a good one. Work hard and enjoy your learning.